Okay, thank you very much. Very kind introduction. First of all, I'd like to say the sincere congratulations for the 150th anniversary of BASF. And also, it is my great honor to be invited to this memorial symposium. Today is my talking on the challenge of the eco-friendly plastics based on the biodegradable plastics and the bio-based plastics. So today my talking has three parts. One is a general introduction. What is a biodegradable plastics? What is a bio-based plastics as an university lectures? Second one, I'd like to introduce our recently laboratory's works result. And finally, I would like to share what must we do in future in this bio-based and biodegradable plastics. Okay, so everybody knows that plastics are produced from the fossil resources, molded into various shapes and forms, and light, strong, and tough, long-lasting. It is no doubt that plastic is one of the greatest products in 20th centuries. For establishment of a sustainable society, we must develop that. Two new types of plastics. One is the bio-based plastics. This is for the reduce of the consumption of the fossil resources and to prevent earth warming. The second one is the biodegradable plastics. This is for the keeping the global environmental conservation. But sometimes the people, these two plastics is confusing. This one, by the definition of the biodegradable plastics, plastics degraded by the action of the microorganism into the carbon dioxide and water. In the case of the bio-based plastics, plastics should be produced from the materials or the product derived from the biomass, mainly the plant biomass. This is one example of the biodegradation test of the biodegradable plastics. If we focus on this part, you can see that so many degrading microorganisms are covered on the biodegradable plastic surface. However, degrading microorganisms do not eat the plastic directly. This is the biodegradation schemes of the microorganism. Microorganisms secrete depolymerase outside the bodies. This depolymerase soaked on the plastic surface. Normally, the plastic is water-insoluble materials. So this depolymerase hydrolyzes these water-insoluble materials to the water-soluble products, monomer and dimers. These water-soluble materials metabolize inside the body, inside the microbial body, and then convert it to the carbon dioxide and the water and the biomass. Accordingly, biodegradability is one of the properties and they're linked to the chemical structures. Ecoflex is produced for the BASF from the oils. I obtained this picture from the homepage of the BASF. So after the 4 weeks, this Ecoflex completely degraded in soils. Polylactic acid is one of the bio-based and biodegradable plastics. This was produced from the sugarcane and the cornstarch. Why is that these polymers degraded in environments? Because both plastics has ester bonding. Hydrolysis attacks this ester bond and then cuts the polymer chain. Accordingly, I would like to emphasize that biodegradability is linked to the chemical structure. So next one is the bio-based plastics. Plastics produced from the materials or the product derived from the biomass. But what is the biomass? Biomass is biological material derived from the living or recently living organism. Sometimes some researchers say oil is also produced from the biomass. But in this definition, now is the biomass is derived from the living or recently living organism. Then the crops, agricultural residues, and food waste, virgin wood, and industrial waste, and co-products. Okay, this one, the comparison of the oil-based plastics and bio-based plastics. In the case of the oil-based plastics, the raw material obtained from oil as naphtha, and then processed energy also getting by the oil energy. Now, at the present, so bio-based polymer produced from the sugars, this one is the edible materials. Processed energy obtained from the oils. In future, we must change this edible material to the non-edible material to produce the bio-based plastics. This one is the use amount of the fossil resources and amount of the emission of the global warming gas during the production of the bio-based plastics and the oil-based plastics. In the case of the oil-based polymers, you can see the two use amount of the fossil resources. However, in the case of the bio-based polymer, it is not necessary to the feedstock energies. Accordingly, the total used amount of the fossil resources is reduced, and also the amount of the emission of the global warming gas, mainly the carbon dioxide, is decreased when to prepare the bio-based polymers. Okay, so now I say that in the viewpoint of the resources, now we changed from the oil-based to the bio-based, and also plastic has the biodegradability or non-biodegradability. We can classify the plastic into four categories. This one is so oil-based plastics and non-biodegradable plastics, polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, typical common plastics. In oil-based plastics, I would say the Ecoflex, the polybutylene succinates, some plastics has the biodegradability. When changing to the resources from the oil to the renewable resources, but there is two types of the bio-based plastics. For example, biopolyethylene is a completely same chemical structure oil-based polyethylene. Accordingly, this biopolyethylene has not the biodegradability. This one here part is polylactic acid, microbial polyesters, low degree of substitution polysaccharide derivatives produced from the renewable resources and has the biodegradability. Accordingly, we must consider that bio-based plastic is not the biodegradable plastics. Sometimes we find out the food packaging films. This film is made from biopolyethylene derived from the plant. However, accordingly, this film is completely biodegradable in environment. This is wrong. Biopolyethylene is not degraded in environment because this chemical structure is completely the same as the oil-based plastics. Okay, so accordingly, we must satisfy to donated the certification of the symbol marks of the biodegradable plastics because we cannot distinguish which film is a biodegradable plastic, so which film is a non-biodegradable plastic in picture. So now is the ISO standards established for the degradation test. In Japan, biodegradable plastic is called the green plastics. So United States is a compostable mark. In Germany, the compostable marks are already donated. Several years ago, I visited the Nobel museums. I bought the Nobel chocolate. I received to the plastic bag. So this plastic bag mentioned that this bag is 100 compostables, and this mark is already attached. So if you have a chance to visit the Nobel museums, please buy the Nobel chocolate and see these plastic films. You can find out that this film is completely biodegradable. Okay, this one, the global production the capacities of the bioplastics. Now is 2015, so almost same as the amount of the biodegradable plastic, the bio-based plastics. In futures, European bioplastics in the Japanese Bioplastic Society estimate is that this bio-based and non-biodegradable plastic should be increased. What kind of bio-based plastics should be produced? I think there are three categories. One is a polymer that has identical structures as polyethylene, polypropylene, and polyethylene terephthalate, as biopolyethylene and bio-PET 30. But this one is non-biodegradable plastics. Second one is a polymer that have similar properties as polyethylene and polypropylene. So for example, the polylactic acids, microbial polyesters is in these categories. This polymer has the biodegradabilities. The third one is now we use to the biomass accordingly, polymer that have new structure and properties that can only be produced from the biomass. I would like to explain these samples of these polymers. Now is a method and the production has already established to obtain the bio or polyethylene from the bioethanol. Now is the biopolyethylene is 100 produced from the renewable resources. In the case of the bio-PET, yesterday and today, the polyethylene terephthalate bottle is collected in outside the conference unit. And then this one is maybe the oil-based polyethylene. But some part, the Coca-Cola is already produced to the bio-PET 30. This one, the 30, is the biomass content. Now is the ethylene glycol part has already established to the bioethanol. But now the terephthalic acid part is produced from the fossil resources. In some Japanese companies, so already established to produce with the terephthalic acid from the fruit flowers like this. Accordingly, in future, the polyethylene terephthalate changes to the completely completely 100 biomass. This is the global production capacities of the bioplastics. Here parts, red part is the biodegradable plastics. Green part is the bio-based plastics. Now, in future, this part is more increased as the bio-based bioplastics. Okay, second one is a polymer that has similar properties as polyethylene, polypropylene. That means that thermal properties and the mechanical properties are almost the same, but this polymer has the biodegradabilities. So polylactic acid, so 20 years ago, this was established to be produced from the sugarcane and the corn. Firstly, sacrificed to the obtain the starch, and then this starch hydrolyzed to the glucose. And then if alcohol fermentation applied this glucose, using the glucose, we can obtain the bioethanol. When applied to the lactic fermentation, we obtain to the, this lactic acid monomer. And then there is a chemical synthesis procedure to obtain the polylactic acid. This one has already used to the food packaging field and the agricultural mulch films and crop storing and composting bag because this plastic is completely composting. And also, this polylactic acid used is some part is the blister pack, one part of the computers, and the part of the printer and the floor mat. Matsuda and the Teijin Fiber in the Japanese companies has processed the stereocomplex polylactic acid. So polylactic acid, the melting temperature is 170 degrees of Celsius. This is close to the polypropylene. So normally the polyesters, polyethylene terephthalate has the melting temperature is close to 217. Accordingly, this stereocomplexation is very effective to increase to the melting temperature. And then Teijin fibers succeeded to produce the fabric. Then Mazda Automobile Company used to this fiber in the sheet of the car. This one is an announcement of the, from the Toyota. The Toyota has already used to the more than the 80% of the inner part bio-based plastics. But normally, the, this one, the blend, the polylactic acid blend with the polypropylene, polylactic acid blended polyethylene terephthalate. But the, over the 80% inner part has already used in the bio-based polymers. Okay, in this biodegradable bio-based plastics, we must always think is how to synthesize new bio-based and biodegradable plastics, and then, and also the how to develop the new processing method to increase the mechanical properties, and then why is that these samples has increased the mechanical properties and thermal property. We must relieve it to the three-dimensional molecular and three-dimensional structure. And also, some bio-based plastics has a biodegradability and biocompatibilities. Accordingly, we must to relieve the, how to degrade it, these materials. So total science to required in this bio-based and biodegradable plastics. So today, I would like to briefly introduce the introduction for the one example with the high-performance microbial polyesters. So firstly, the microbial production and the processing the strong fiber and the relieve the structure analysis. And I would like to control the enzymatic rate of the enzymatic degradation and biocompatibility. And also, second one, I would like to introduce the polysaccharides because there are so many kind of unique polysaccharides in nature. We must use to the, this polysaccharides in future. And also, I would like to introduce some enzymatic polymerization, not use the organic solvent in the water condition, and also not chemical reaction. Enzymatic esterification, I would like to introduce. Okay, this one is a typical is a microbial polyesters. This one is discovered in 1925 in France, a Pasteur Institute. Some microorganisms produced to the polyesters directly from the sugar, fatty acid, and plant oils. This is a transmission electron microscopy of the microorganism accumulated the, these biopolyesters inside the bodies. Okay, this one the over the 80%, 90% accumulated these polymer inside the body. The properties of this biopolyesters is close to the polyethylene. Thermal property is close to the polyethylene. However, mechanical properties is not so good. Accordingly, so during the 19 years, nobody can use these materials. So, because some crystal is generated at keeping at the room temperature and easy to break like this. So to improve the physical properties, most of the researchers and the companies try to the copolymerization by using changes the carbon resources and genetic engineer the microorganism. Then now is in submitted paper, there is over the 150 kind of the copolyester are already reported. However, only the three or four copolymer has already started to the pilot plant production. I and Kaneka company, in Japanese companies, do the national project, and then the, now is Kaneka company establishment to the 1,000 ton per year production of the microbial polyester copolymers. And this was the one example of the microbial polyester goods, shampoo bottle and the wax films, and the one-way usage is a fork and a knife. These and it produced from the palm oils by the microorganisms inside the body, and then this was completely degraded in environment. In our laboratories, we'd like to increase to the mechanical properties. So we try to do the, to produce the super high molecular weight polymers by the recombinant E. coli. when change it to we produce the recombinant E. coli and then search to the cultivation condition, we obtain the very, very high molecular weight, about the 14 million. So it's impossible to the chemical reaction. So now we succeed to obtain the very high, huge high molecular biodegradable polymers. And then we succeeded, we developed a new drawing techniques, and then we can succeed it to obtain the high tensile strength biodegradable fibers. So it's the tensile strength over the 1 gigapascal. Accordingly, these fibers can be used the surgical sutures or the fishing line and like this. And also it is impossible to use the reinforced the materials. This was the other techniques, and then the, against the commercial PHA. That's one is now is the world bio-based polymers has increased the mechanical properties compared than the polylactic acid and the oil-based plastics. Why is that? These polymers has changed to the high tensile fibers. We relieve the molecular structure by using the synchrotron radiation. This one, in Japan, there is a big facility at the synchrotron radiation, super photon ring is 8 GeV. This world largest third generation synchrotron radiation can be used to the polymer structure analysis and protein structure analysis. Today, my talking on the, I would like to introduce the three-dimensional protein structure analysis. Okay, this one is a reason why is that this polymer changed to the strong fiber. So normally, the, this microbial polyester has a helix conformation. However, in this two strong fibers, there is a new molecular conformation. This was a planar zigzag conformation. This molecular chain has its contribute to the increased mechanical property. That means that we can control the mechanical property is the molecular chain. This fiber is a completely degraded environment. So this is the morphology before the environmental degradation, after the partial enzymatic environmental degradation in sea waters. After the 3 weeks, so five strong fiber degraded from the surface, we would like to control the rate of the biodegradability. So some biodegradation plastics degraded inside the body over the 10 days. But some plastics degraded the environment for the during the 3 months. So we'd like to control the rate of the biodegradation. Accordingly, we searched to the degrading microorganisms and isolated to the polymers, depolymerase from the seawater, freshwater, the soil water, and we released a one-dimensional sequence of the amino acid. So normally, depolymerase has the two important functions. One is the substrate binding domain. So normally, the hydrolase adsorbed on the plastic surface, and then catalytic domain, in the catalytic domain, is the cut the polymers. So there is a two important functions. So nobody knows exactly the depolymerase adsorbed on the materials. We can see the evidence. So this is the adsorption of the depolymerase on the crystal surface. So you can see the very small particle on the crystal surface. This is the direct evidence. So depolymerase adsorbed on the plastic surface and then degrading the plastics as like this. And also, the, when change it to the crystallinity of the polymer, we can control of the rate of the erosion. And now I say that strong fiber has the two molecular conformation. If applied to the enzymatic degradation test, so helix conformation remained unchanged. However, planar zigzag conformation is the faster degraded than the 2-1 helix conformation. So based this result, we can control the degradation rate by the molecular structure. So this one is a three-dimensional crystal structure of the depolymerase. So here part is the catalytic domain. When there is a polymer chain inside this catalytic domain, and then cut this one. In future, we must design the artificial enzyme for non-biodegradable polymers. So this one is a mouse of the catalytic domain. If changing this amino acid as a point mutation, so this mouse is a whole is slightly longer. Accordingly, the other polymer can be entered this catalytic domain. If this valine residue changes to the other amino acid, so this whole is shape is different. Accordingly, we can make the design the artificial enzyme for the non-biodegradable polymers. Okay, this polymer has the biocompatibility. Some biodegradable plastics has the biocompatibility. So this one is an example of the biocompatibility of the microbial polyesters. Okay, so you can see that when changed to the amount of the second monomer units, we can control the rate of the biocompatibility. This is a nanofiber shapes. Okay, this is a histological section of the nanofibers. After the 4 weeks, after the 12 weeks, so you can see the white area. This one is a nanofiber. For example, in the case of the 4HB, at first, after the 4 weeks, you can see the many inflammatory cells. However, after that, the nanofiber biocompatible inside the body, these inflammatory cells completely disappears. Accordingly, some biodegradable plastics has a biocompatibility, and then the rate of the biocompatibility can be controlled with the chemical structure. Okay, now I introduce to the high-performance microbial polyesters and integrated science. In future, we must use the polysaccharides. So polymer that has new structure and properties can be produced from the biomass. So this one is one example of the polysaccharide. So a human cannot produce to these polysaccharides. So cellulose is one of the very important, much abundant polysaccharide in the world. Then, so obtained from the wood. Glucomannan, this one is also obtained from the wood and or the cognac. But these ones, almost same chemical structure. However, one part is different. In Ugrana, this is produced to this beta-1,3 glucan from the carbon dioxide directly. Oh, this one, this cardoran, beta-1,3 glucan is similar to the cellulose, but this linkage part is a difference. The sugar is the glucose. This one is glucose, this one is glucose. However, the glucose linkage part is different. In the cellulose is the beta-1,4 linkage. However, the cardoran is a 1,3 linkage. Accordingly, this cellulose has a linear structure. However, the cardoran is a helix structure. And then, so some microorganism produced to the other polysaccharide. This one is a pleuron. It's linked to the alpha-1,4, the alpha-1,6 linkage. This one also the glucose. If these polysaccharides degrade to the monomers, we can obtain only the glucose. However, in nature, produce to the unique structures. These structures are not used, not produced human. Accordingly, we must keep this structure and then modify to the good thermoplastics. This is one example. It's a very simple method for the esterification. But this is a chemical reaction. So there are the three kind of the hydroxy groups, change it to the acyl groups. This one is the crystalline polymers. So if we produce the cardoran modified esters, so this one is the thermal properties. So, for example, polyethylene terephthalate has a glass transition temperature is 70 degrees Celsius, and the melting temperature is 270 degrees Celsius. However, in the polysaccharide, cardolan esters has a higher glass transition temperature, is about 180, and the melting temperature also close to the polyethylene terephthalate. Accordingly, the polysaccharide has much possibility to become the excellent thermoplasticity. This one is already possible to make the melt-spun fiber without the additives. This one, one example of the amorphous polymers. So cognac glucomannan, cognac is produced to the glucomannan. This one also the glucose unit and the mannose unit. So when you apply the chemical modification, so for example, this was the amorphous polymers. So all base amorphous polymers, the polystyrene has the glass transition temperature is close to 100 degrees. Polycarbonate is 125. So in the case of the glucomannan acetate, we can control the glass transition temperature, so degree of the acceleration. So, and also we can prepare the strong films and the soft films desired. And then it's possible to change in the mechanical properties one kind of the acyl groups. This one is the property of the plural derivatives. So this one is a very high transparent films. So normally the protective films, so cellulose acetate that they use. However, in the case of the plural acetate, the out of the plane biofluorescence is completely zero. So depend on the wavelength. Accordingly, now I would like to say again the polysaccharide change it to the good sum plastics. In recent years, our laboratories tried to produce unnatural type polysaccharide by the enzymatic polymerization. So this one is one of the gluconsuccinase. The carbon resources is the sucrose. Then so these enzymes can be produced to the unnatural type of the polysaccharide alpha-1,3-glucan. And then this enzymatic polymerization completely linearly as no branches polymers. And also the recently, so it's possible to the enzymatic esterification. So normally the chemical modification is applied to added some plasticity in the polysaccharide. So now is we can produce to the new polymer by the enzymatic polymerization, and then some plasticity added to the enzymatic esterification. This enzymatic polymerization and the enzymatic modification is a very eco-friendly reaction systems because the wall reaction can be due to the water-based medium, and then the reaction temperature is the room temperature is okay, the 25 degrees Celsius and like this. And also, enzyme has a high specificity. Accordingly, we can modify the regioselectivity reaction. In future, in this bio-based biodegradable plastic must use to the added help to the enzyme because the enzyme should be the good catalysis. Okay, now we can obtain so many kinds of the polysaccharide from the plant and the microorganisms and the carbons like this. And also the non-natural polysaccharide can be produced from the enzymatic polymerization. And then the high-performance some plastics should be changed to the, by the enzymatic modification. In the last, I would like to share the, what must we do in future in this bio-based and biodegradable plastics. The 5 years, next 5 years, so we must always better understanding structure and properties relationship. And also the plastic must used in the various fields. Accordingly, the improvement is require thermal and mechanical property. And also the new copolymer and modified polysaccharide should be developed. In next 10 years, we can obtain the aromatic component from the renewable resources. This one is estimated the chemical structure of the three-dimensional chemical structure of the lignin. Lignin is one of the important resources obtained from the wood. However, nobody knows that these three-dimensional structure, and also nobody knows the, what the linkage occurs in the lignin. Firstly, we must leave to the lignin structure and then obtain it to the aromatic component from the lignin. And also, efficient fermentation process should be required from the non-edible feedstock, not used to the sugarcane and the cornstarch. Okay, and the next 15 years, so we must correct to the library as the novel monomer structure, and also establishment of the eco-friendly chemical or enzymatic reaction. So reaction should be better to the water condition, and the room temperature condition is the best. And so we must to correct the catalog of the designed polymer property. In next 20 years, ability to assemble controls highly ordered structures. Okay, in the last part, I would like to emphasize next generation bio-based biodegradable plastics should not be produced from the non-edible biomass, but also show a superior performance because the plastics must be used in various fields. We must develop an in-depth understanding of the structure of the biomass. Biomass is a very complicated structure. So we must always think is what happened in the biomass, what structure is the biomass. So understanding the structure of the biomass and then modifying this structure and the properties little by little. Not, it is impossible to drastically change. So little by change is the most. I would like to emphasize biomass researchers, microbiologists, synthetic chemists, and process engineers should collaborate these fields in future. So I'd like to say that strongly this collaboration is this depend on the researchers. Last, I would like to say my laboratory members and received to so many so much the National Foundation from Japan. In the last, I would like to say again the congratulations for the 150th anniversary of the BASF. So thank you very much for the kind attention.